So the first group we're gonna actually have a look at would be salicylates. And salicylates are made up of a phenol group, yeah. That is, this OH group is ortho to the carboxylic acid. One of the best examples of salicylates would be aspirin. It's been around for more than 100 years, and it's been used for the treatment of mild to moderate pain and fever. Of recently, for the past about 10 to 15 years, it's been used as an anticoagulant, yeah, to reduce the chances of people getting heart attack, in a sense. Okay. So how was aspirin discovered? Around 1800, around that time, yeah, there's this production of coal tar. Yeah, one of the byproducts of this steam distillation of coal tar is phenol. And it came out as phenol oil, and it's actually used extensively in the surgical theater, yeah, to prevent wound sepsis. And people thought that if they actually, a phenol can be used to prevent wound sepsis externally, can it actually also be used to prevent infection internally, you know? So back then, there was a belief that, you know, if you actually change a bit of the phenol group, add on a carboxylic acid, yeah. In this case, is salicylic acid. And taken internally, it can act as an internal antiseptic, okay, to reduce infection by gut bacteria. And it's also less corrosive than phenol. All right. So it was a success because it was found to be effective in reducing the fever, therefore it's an effective antibiotic. It was also then found to reduce inflammation and pain for arthritic patient. Good, yeah. So it's way, in a sense, better than the problems with phenol, that is phenol's corrosive for external use, therefore it can't be taken in. So it's having the carboxylic acid makes it way better, yeah. And also, actually, the active component of the salicylic acid was found, has been shown by Buckner, that the pain relieving agent in willow bark extract is salicin, is this salicylic acid moiety. Okay. So next, people thought, okay. Because the problem with the salicylic acid is unpalatable, it's bitter, it doesn't taste good. Can you change the taste of this good agent, good antibiotic, anti-inflammatory agent, by changing the moiety, yeah, of this on the structure? So they add on a phenol group here, make it into a phenol ester. So this phenol salicylic acid is found to be insoluble in stomach. It gets broken down in small intestine. This is a really good an early example of slow release medicine. Yeah. So it's fantastic. It's good. It's working, but it gives inconsistent therapeutic responses. Yeah. Sometimes you can actually reduce fever, sometimes it doesn't. So, as a summary, if you can take the first set off with phenol, yeah. So, how this is just to show you how aspirin was discovered. So, set off phenol, yeah. Problem is, it's too corrosive, yeah. And then add on a carboxylic acid next, also to the OH group. You got salicylic acid, it's bitter, it's unpalatable. You modify the carboxylic acid, yeah, into a phenol ester, in a sense. It's good, okay, but the therapeutic responses is inconsistent. So then people thought, okay, why not change, yeah, remove that phenol group. Keep it as a carboxylic acid and then just change the OH group, to an acetal group. All right. So this was, these all this thinking, in a sense, was done by many scientists, but the key scientist is Hoffman, a chemist in Bayer, who thought that just mask the OH group can eliminate the corrosiveness of phenol, and you can also ensure that the once in the stomach, the ester group will fall off and form the parent molecule, that is the salicylic acid. Fantastic. By the way, the acetal aspirin originates from the yeast, originates from acetal. The aspirin is, originates from Dispiria ulmaria. Okay. So just to show you that the discovery of aspirin came about from phenol. Then it went on to, you know, start off with the caparin salicylic acid, and then modification of the carboxylic acid gives phenyl salicylic acid. Didn't work as it was successful, but the therapeutically it was inconsistent. Then somebody actually Hoffman especially she came thought of acetylating the OH group rather than the carboxylic acid, then that is the birth of the acetyl salicylic acid.